So I did mushrooms a long time ago.
Oh, like drugs?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Yeah.
Look what happened when you did mushrooms. Huh?
So my dad was an interior designer. We had a fish pond, a koi pond in my living room. Uh-huh. You know, we had these big kois in there, probably about 10, 12 of them. So I'm sitting there and I'm looking at the fish and I'm like, hey man, the fish are trying to tell me something. And they're swimming in a circle, right? They'd go in a circle and then they'd stop and they'd spill a letter, right? And I'm like, hey man, give me a pencil and a paper, man. These fish are trying to tell me something, man. So I wrote it all down. And when I finally-
Every letter.
So when they finally got done, they go, what's it say? I said, it says, go to Del Taco. So we all went to Del Taco and ate a shitload of Mexican food
for them.
Mushrooms. The fish talked to you with mushrooms.
They did, man. They told me to go get some tacos.
That is pretty crazy shit.
That was good. I'm telling you.
And right there at that moment, that was really happening.
That was back in the day.
It was really happening, right?
It happened.
They were spelling you those.
I swear to God, dude. They were swimming in a circle and it was like, G. Oh, T. They stopped. It was a trip, dude.
Did you ever do mushrooms again after that?
No, that was it. I only did it once.
Tell him what the fish told him.
Y dice que porque estaba mirando los pescados que él miraba que estaban mal y que estaban deletreando algo, le estaban haciendo una y que le dijeron que fuera a comer algo del taco.
Were the tacos good that day?
Great, dude. Red burrito, a couple tacos. Good.
Isn't that crazy? I was telling him about this MMA coach that I know that did a video with me how to eat mushrooms, like how to do the drugs. He was bringing me, and the video in one day had 80,000, and then he called me when he got sober, take it down.
Oh, is that right? Well, why did you have to take it down?
Because he was embarrassed that everybody saw him do mushrooms. But he was probably high when I came to his gym.
Well, didn't he know the camera was there?
Of course he knew, but maybe it looked cool when he was high.
Well, I can tell you, those mushrooms can get you spun a little bit, dude.
Why did you do them? Just to try it?
Yeah.
But it was fun.
It was back in the 80s, dude. That was back in the 80s.
Robert, you never did mushrooms?
Never.
Have you done mushrooms? But isn't that crazy?
You know, I know a lot of people.
What do you do?
Look up. I do masonry, man.
What's that?
The bricks. Bricks.
Mason.
Bricks.
Here's what I did yesterday and today.
Right down the street.
No, right down the street, dude. Right about two doors down. Oh, come on. I don't want that. Just go to the freaking albums. I just did the stonework.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Inside of this house.
That is sick.
Nice. They're gonna do that always on the wall.
That's a fountain. Indoor fountain that goes on that. That was inside. Okay. Yeah, that was inside.
Oh, but you also do like fences sometimes.
No, that's what I did the other day.
You also do concrete?
I do concrete. Those are some caps and walls.
Robert was thinking of expanding the gym. Gates.
Hey man, let's build up mailboxes, all that kind of stuff. Okay. Hey, check this out, dude. I also do art. You're gonna like this one now. Hang on.
Do you have to be a mushroom to do this work?
I make hot chicks. Check out these chicks, dude. All right, ready? There's a chick. She's all American. You see her?
Oh, yeah.
See her arm and her boobies?
But that's like your hobby, right?
That's my hobby.
That's like your hobby.
There's one chick.
What do you make it out of?
I make them out of mirrors and marbles.
Yeah.
Ooh,
that's cool.
Yeah.
That's some good art.
There's my chicks, man.
You could do a boxing one.
See, that's how I started. Yeah, man. I'll make one of a bull for the gym. I can make that bull.
Yeah?
Dude. I can make you a badass bull.
That'd be sick.
I'll make one. I'll make a bull.
I'll make a bull.
Pita.
You want some now?
Oh, to give them some.
Let me tell you why you shouldn't do mushrooms.
What?
He did mushrooms, and the fish in a pond started talking to him. And he was writing down the words that they were spelling.
I'm going to try that once before I die.
And you know what the spelling, what came out in
the end? I'll try it once before I die.
You know,
Joe Rogan always talks about psychedelic,
experiences
and stuff, and I want to try.
Guess what the fish? Can you guess?
Can you guess? Be one time.
Yeah.
What are you gonna addicted to that shit?
Guess what the fish told him to do?
What?
Go to Del Taco.
If it's good, then you're gonna try it again. Cause if it's so good, then again.
Yeah.
And then it becomes.
You know what? I wouldn't do it, dude.
I'm gonna try it once.
Don't do it. Just get the mushrooms of Stater Brothers with some butter.
Yeah.
That's the way to do mushrooms right there. Mushrooms on your burger. mushrooms on your steak or something.
Robert, this is the funniest mushroom story I've heard. They usually don't end. They usually don't end good.
No, but there you did believe that. They spelled
it.
It was
real, dude. It was like really happening.
Yeah, it happened.
I swear to you, it was like they were going in a circle.
Were you with your friends or by yourself?
I was with about 3 or 4.
And what did they say? Did they see the same shit or?
No, they didn't see what I saw. They didn't see it. I said, go get the pencil and paper, man. They're talking to me. You're spelling something to me. I gotta write it down. Word. It's the truth.
That's crazy.
It was wild. Back in the day.
Have you ever tried weed?
Yeah.
No effects on you?
Weed? Come on, man. Weed always has an effect.
What effect?
It makes you buzz.
Paranoid? Some people get paranoid.
You know what?
When I tried the brownies, that shit fucked me up.
Sometimes it does.
We were driving to some fights. Herbert was fighting that day. So we were driving, and I was.
When you had your meeting,
my shake at Denny's. That was the best fucking shake I've ever had. I had two strawberry shakes at Denny's. I ate that shit so good. Fucking shakes.
Have you ever tried Coke?
Back in the 80s.
Does it give you energy? Does it make you lose weight? Does it make you like go a million miles an hour?
Weren't you talking about Oscar De La Hoya being president?
Yes, he wants to be president.
Well, that would be a White House, dude.
Right?
I don't know. Well, I don't know because Oscar, he maybe did it in the past. I don't know if he's
done
it anymore.
Oh, yeah, you know what? No, yeah. I don't want to say anything.
But what effects does it have on you when you do it?
It kind of makes you feel pumped up.
Superman.
Right? Pumped up, Superman.
I never done that.
There was one fighter who took it, but he still got knocked out. The guy from Northern California, he fought Gamboa.
Eloy Perez,
and he got knocked out, and then he rolled.
Did you get tested for that?
Yeah.
He tested positive.
They test them after.
So you default, right? You lose no matter what.
Yeah.
You win, you lose. Don't do drugs.
What about steroids? You ever done steroids?
No.
No steroids?
Does that look ripped up enough as it is? Do you think I need steroids?
That's not a fun drug?
I don't know, man. I've never done it.
Meth?
Fuck no.
But that's a dangerous one.
Shit. You see people on meth, dude? They are... Dude, that's...
Why would someone even try that? Why would you even try that?
That's like you said, dude. When you try it one time and you like it...
Yeah.
Try it one time knowing that it makes your skin, your teeth, your...
I don't know, man. Sometimes it's peer pressure.
Right, exactly.
Sometimes you're trying to fit in.
Like crack, same thing, crack? Mad, you
know, I don't know. I've never done crack, dude.
No, that was big in the 80s, too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
No.
When we were driving that day, it was the first time ever, and that's the only time...
Did you know they were laced or no?
I knew, but see, the thing is that when you have a piece, it doesn't do shit to you to like fucking...
It kicks
an hour
in.
Later. So
yeah.
I had a piece and nothing. Then I have another. So I had a whole fucking brownie. By the time it hit me, it was like really bad.
Yeah.
So I was driving. I wasn't even driving. No, I don't remember who was driving. But Donald and Herbert were in the back, and they were just talking. And to me, it sounded like they were like singing. And I was fucking playing music. Boom! I was playing music, and they were like just laughing at me. And then I got mad at them because I thought they were talking shit about me. It was just crazy. Then we had at Denny's. Fucking those two fucking shakes, the best shakes I've ever had.
Denny's just sponsor you. You should do commercials
best
for them.
Best shakes I've ever had, I swear to
God. Hey, it's legal now to fly throughout LAX with weed. They changed the law.
Yeah.
So now Denny's can really sponsor you because it's legal.
Best fucking shake I've ever had.
But you know, there are some benefits.
That's the only time I drive.
What does Joe Rogan say?
Hey, Joe Rogan smokes weed, don't he? Wasn't him and Elon Musk? Wasn't he the one that was... interviewing Elon Musk when Elon Musk was puffing.
Yeah.
What happened? I saw Joe Rogan on the other side of the mic. I'm like, is that Joe Rogan over there?
Yeah, what did you say, Robert, when you did it?
You know what? One more. He just reminded me one more time when I went to court. I didn't know. And actually, that was the first time.
You went to court on weed?
I was high on that shit. But see, I tried it early in the morning. But that shit takes like fucking 6 hours to go away.
And what happened in court?
I told the guy that was representing me, I said, you do all the fucking talking, I ain't even gonna fucking open my mouth. And then he did all the talking, he just introduced me, I'm like, hi.
You know what I do now, man? I do bee pollen.
What's that?
Bee pollen, it's the pollen on the bees. You see the bees
flying around?
Did that get you high? No, it's good for you, man, it's healthy.
I thought it gives you a buzz.
Bee pollen and royal jelly. That's what the bees make the kids.
There's a problem that there's the bees are dying off on the face of the planet. There's less.
You gotta get all the pollen you can before it's too late.
What happened?
Well, there are less and less.
Didn't I
bees.
Hear that if there's no, like, if Earth can't, like, needs the bees?
They need them for the flowers, the plants, the fruit, because they
pollinate, man. They pollinate everything.
It's crazy.
I found a lady up in Oak Glen that sells it, and you got to keep it in the freezer so it stays fresh. I do like a little shot glass, half a shot glass of bee pollen in the morning and at night.
Bring it here. We want to try it. Does it taste like honey?
I'll bring it. No, it's like
tastes
little,
like
it's
shit.
Like little. No, it tastes pretty good. But I just swallow it.
But I gotta ask you this though. There's some people like Nick Diaz and Nate Diaz that can smoke weed 24/7 and it doesn't affect them at all.
That's because you build up a tolerance. If you smoke dope every day, dude, it takes you more and more to smoke, to get high. It's a tolerance. It gets in your system, man.
But it doesn't affect them at all. They function normally.
Let's get ready.
Well, who are you sparring today?
It doesn't affect you.
Are you ready to spar again?
Not really, no.
It's just like, dude, they're all just like, you know. It kind of makes you like mediocre, dude. You just kind of keep, I'm not saying that Diaz is mediocre by any means, but I'm saying, it just kind of makes you like.
No, they,
you know,
I'm telling you.
I don't care. Kind of what? I want them to be motivated. Fuck it, let's watch TV.